The following is a Hoop Ball presentation.
Hoop Ballers, it is I, Lyle Swithenbank, back with another episode of the Pelican Scoop. I'm joined with a very special guest today, Mark Romig, Chief Marketing Officer of the New Orleans and Company, as well as the stadium announcer at the Superdome for the Saints. Mark, how are you going?
Good morning. It's going fine. Good evening to you. Good morning here.
Yes. No, we managed to sync up the time zones and bring it all together. I really appreciate you spending a bit of time with us this morning and chatting about New Orleans with us.
My pleasure. It's, Australia and New Orleans have been seeing a lot of each other over the past several years. We've seen, an increase in visitors from Australia to New Orleans for their love of jazz and music and the food, of course. And it's always a pleasure to talk to our friends.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And as I said off air, I was absolutely over the moon that you were able to join us. And hopefully we can get some awesome insights about New Orleans in general, perhaps some Saints stats as well. And then maybe we'll talk a bit of Pels as well if we have time.
It'd be my pleasure.
Yeah, that's awesome. I mean, New Orleans, it's sort of got its own vibrancy, its own vibe, its own, I suppose, when you think of New Orleans, you think of the jazz, you think of the food like you talked about. What would you describe as the biggest draw cards to New Orleans? What makes people come there?
You know, Lyle, New Orleans just celebrated its 300th anniversary as a city just 2 years ago in 2018. And it gave us time to reflect on those things that have made New Orleans such a special place for so many years. And I think we all landed on the fact that so many cultures came together over the last several centuries to make New Orleans what it is. You have not only the European culture, strong African culture, strong Caribbean culture, strong Asian culture. People from all over the world have settled in New Orleans, it being a port city. And so with that came the music that they brought with them, the drums from the Caribbean and from Africa, and the spices from all parts of the world, and the types of cooking that now go on. It's just an infusion of all sorts of styles. And then, of course, people say that they go to New Orleans and instead of going to Europe because it's the most European city in the United States. And there's something to say about that because the architecture reflects a lot of that old style. Our French Quarter, which is actually Spanish architecture, the French Quarter and the Garden District and all the parks and just that, the friendliness of the people here. We say that when you come to New Orleans, you'll always leave with a story. Somebody will have met someone they love. They would have danced until 2 o'clock in the morning on Frenchman Street, or they may have eaten the most delicious po' boy sandwich that they've ever had, but they always leave with a story. And so we say that you leave with a story, not just a souvenir. It's just magical things happen in New Orleans.
Absolutely. I mean, I was there in 2017, as I was telling you off air, and I was there for the Voodoo Fest and Halloween, and the city transforms. I mean, it was like anything else that I've ever seen. I was lucky. I did a bit of a road trip around with one of my friends. We went all over the South and the East and West Coast as well. But you're exactly right with the stories that New Orleans leaves you. You know, we had no plans whatsoever. We ended up in the French Quarter and on Halloween night, and everyone's carrying on. It's just so much fun. And, you know, I don't think there's anywhere like that in the world. You're exactly right with the European comparisons as well. You know, it is just, it's its own beast, I suppose. And just great fun.
We're also seen as the most northern Caribbean city as well. I mean, we just have so much of the influence from around the world here.
Just the diversity. I love that you could go and have European food. You can go and have, the Caribbean food, the Haitian food. There's so many different influences throughout the area. And I just think that's just awesome. I think that's so cool.
And we have over 40 museums in New Orleans. One of the more famous ones is the National World War II Museum. It's the congressionally sanctioned museum to honor those that fought and participated in World War II. As you know, the Allied forces on both the European theater as well as the Pacific theater. And we tell that great story. And That's a draw in itself, and that's just another opportunity for people to come together and learn in New Orleans and be educated and then leave with another story.
Yeah, we managed to get there, and that is just, that's massive. That is so in-depth, and it gives so many different stories and all the different floors, and you walk in and see the airplanes in the foyer there, and yeah, just awesome. Yeah. I thought they've done a really good job with that. If you were to bring people from outside of New Orleans and take them on a tour, what would you do for a day there? What would you recommend that someone go and do?
That's a great question because, you know, there were so many things that you can do. And we actually did a 24 hours in New Orleans once, where we started at 10 o'clock one night and went all the way to the next day at 10 o'clock at night. I would ensure that you rode a streetcar along St. Charles Avenue. I would ensure that you had beignets and coffee and milk or cafe au lait. I would ensure that you sat on the banks of the Mississippi River and watched the paddle boats steam by. I would get you to the National World War II Museum. I'd get you to the Audubon Zoo and the aquarium. I'd have you do a walking tour through the French Quarter and see some of the oldest buildings in the United States. I would have you go along the banks of the Lake Pontchartrain and watch the sunset. That's on the northern part of the city. We sit between the Mississippi River and Lake Pontchartrain. There's some beautiful sights out there. Yeah, there'd be so many things that you would also need to eat. And so I would make sure that you had red beans and rice. You had a po' boy. You maybe had some oysters Rockefeller. And you had another po' boy. And you had some shrimp and crawfish. You'd probably leave with a couple more pounds.
Yeah, no doubt. And I actually did when I came back. I was very, I suppose, rotund when I left New Orleans all of the food. It was, an absolute awesome experience. That sounds like a great day, and I'm going to have to lock that in and get over there.
You know, I'll book it for you, and I will do it together.
Oh, perfect. That sounds like a great time. I'll hold you to that one. We'll have to do that. That'll be great. On a lower note, unfortunately, we're in a worldwide pandemic at the moment, the COVID-19 outbreak. That has affected, I suppose, the whole world, which, you know, from every city and every town and every country, you know, they've all been impacted. How has New Orleans coped with this?
Well, we have been following a stay-at-home order by our mayor and our governor, and just recently they began phasing us into a more normal, as you want to call it, normal process of getting out of that. So what we've done now is we're into phase one, which allows restaurants to open up to 25% capacity. The mayor would still like us to stay close to home. We're all being asked to wear a face mask and 6 feet distancing just because of the way this virus spreads. And slowly but surely to try to get our economy started up again, because it dealt a pretty heavy blow onto the tourism industry for sure. I mean, this virus is the antithesis of hospitality. You know, people in tourism like to come together and dance and sit down at a table and drink together and eat together. Well, you're not allowed to do that, you know, when this is happening. So we got to do our part to graduate and to get to the other side. So. But it has reduced our occupancy in the hotels to single digits. About half of our hotels are actually not operating right now. A lot of the restaurants, which are mainly small businesses, you know, family owned small businesses, were directly affected, which meant there were job losses and things of that nature. But, you know, it's just not New Orleans. This is happening across the United States and across the world. I think until we get to the other side of a vaccine and some therapeutics to help manage this, I think we'll see a very slow recovery. But we're committed as an organization. We're a destination marketing organization. That's what New Orleans and Company is. And it's our job to message New Orleans around the world and invite people to come spend their money here in our city. And we have not stopped marketing. We're still telling stories on our website, neworleans.com. Is a really good resource to find out what is open, what the schedule is, of what's going to be opening soon. And as soon as we're able to, we'll be marketing to what we call the drive market. About 70% of the people that come to New Orleans come from about an hour and a half flight or a day's drive. And so that's our sweet spot. And that's who we're going to be talking to, because we think that people are going to be more comfortable driving to a destination as opposed to getting on a plane, and at least initially until we get to a vaccine. That's what the consumer research is telling us.
Yeah, you can see it across the world. I know in Perth, we're in phase three now is what they're talking about. So we're in a sort of in-between stage where cafes are now allowed up to 100. I think that happens on, depending on the size of your venue. So that'll happen on Saturday coming, I think so, this week. And then contact sports and the like are coming back. So we're lucky that the rugby league has just started over here, and that started on the weekend. And then we get our Aussie rules football starting up on the 11th of June. So for us, we're sort of getting to some sort of normality. But for a town like New Orleans, where it is such a tourism-based town, a tourism-driven town, how long do you think before people will start us getting back out? Do you think it'll be a vaccine time before we get...
Well, no, I think we'll get people coming in. I mean, this weekend, we were running across people who came in from Chattanooga, Tennessee, or drove over from Mississippi or Alabama. People will start coming in. It's just not going to come in like we are used to. It's just going to take some time. 6 out of 10 people are still leery about, getting out and being contacted by other people. I think they want to ensure that they get to the other side of this. Ultimately, yes, a vaccine will solve a lot of problems. But gradually, I think if we can all do our own personal responsibility to this and, stay 6 feet apart and wear a face mask and just be mindful of what we're doing, I think that's the way to manage it. Our Saints season starts in August with preseason. They have not yet made an announcement as to what that will look like inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. So we're still waiting to hear, will they allow fans, and if they do, how will they be seated? And all that is currently in discussions.
Yeah, it's something that they're going to have to take into consider, because everyone, I think people now are very wary of the big crowds and things like that. Well, a lot of people are. And I know over here we're not having crowds this season from both of our sports. I think for the basketball as well, when we get into that, it'll be a sort of reduced number as well, from all reports, that our season doesn't start until October for us. So it'll be our summer for our basketball, our NBL. But on the Saints, what are they looking like this year? Is that going to be another almost successful season?
I think the coach has put together, along with the general manager, Mickey Loomis, a very good team. Obviously, we got Drew Brees. He'll be back again, and we're counting on him and Michael Thomas, a great wide receiver. We've got Cam Jordan, who is a great defensive player and a leader in his own right. We've got a number of good things happening, and we've got a very interesting conference. We have Tom Brady now in our conference. He plays at Tampa. We're going to be playing Patrick Mahomes, Kansas City, the Super Bowl winning quarterback. We'll be playing our former backup quarterback, Teddy Bridgewater, who took us through the season, the first part of this past season, in a very strong and spectacular way. So I think you've got some great matchups. But my sense is that we have probably the strongest squad we've had, maybe even since our last Super Bowl year. And so we're anticipating an exciting year for sure.
Oh, the atmosphere that comes around the Saints, I think, is just next to none. It's phenomenal. I remember walking in when I went and watched Saints and Bears, and it was 2017, and Michael Thomas was there and Drew Brees, and I was sitting there just phenomenal. You watch the tailgating out the front, and it's unlike anything I'd ever seen before. It's phenomenal.
Yeah, my mom is fond of saying there are only two seasons each year. There's waiting for the Saints season and the Saints season. It's a religion in New Orleans. Everyone, it's an equal opportunity, unity opportunity. That's what I'm saying, is that it brings everybody together. No matter how old you are, what color your skin, where you live, what you do for a living. Everyone is a Saints fan, and it's our common language, and we're very excited about that.
Absolutely. It's just an awesome team, and you can see the diehards over there everywhere you walk. There's Saints memorabilia on just about every second person. So, yeah, very, very, very beloved team, and, yeah, my favourite NFL team as well. I might be I'm all in on New Orleans, I guess.
And then we've got our Pelicans. Our Pelicans are they're going to be going to Orlando to play in what the NBA is doing to pull all the teams together into that one location. And Zion has just electrified our community, very much like Drew Brees has done with the Saints. It's unfortunate for everybody that the season stopped like it did, because I think we're starting to make a bit of a run, and Zion was healthy. And I would expect that we're going to have some exciting play out of him in the next couple of months. The whole team, the whole squad is a great, great group of guys.
That team looks phenomenal. Very excited. And we sort of did hit that hiatus where they shut down the season, and it was a sort of a what if situation where you're sitting there going, But look how good these guys are, and you lose that momentum. We didn't get to see what they could have been. We got 19 games out of Zion playing with the team, and that Alvin Gentry led squad where they just run up and down the court. It's electrifying to watch. Phenomenal.
Yeah, he reminds me a lot of Shaq, Shaquille O'Neal. Just his presence on the court, I'm looking forward to seeing him go against LeBron James as well at some point again.
Absolutely. It'll be a big test. And this Orlando hub that they're building, I think, is a great way to get some sort of basketball and hopefully some sort of conclusion to the season. Fingers crossed that we feature fairly heavily into the postseason if that's how it plays out and that's how they agree to finish it off. But very excited with what is in store.
We're excited about that. And that team is also owned by the same person who owns the New Orleans Saints, Gail Benson. And she's done a terrific job of pulling people together, getting the right talent in the back office and administration and pulling these coaches together. And they're inspired by her. She's a great businesswoman. And I think they're investing it in the right way too.
That's great. I mean, for both those teams to be connected, I mean, they've got similar of the colorways as well. And, I can see that both of them are just so beloved by the fans. And I think that what makes a good side is that they've got the whole fan backing or the whole city's backing behind them as well. And, that in itself is a testament to good management, good ownership and all the way down. So, Mark, before I let you go, I'd just like to ask you, what are your key takeaways, I suppose, or what would you say to someone that was going to come to New Orleans? What are your draw cards, I guess, if you had a couple of words to summarize why someone should come there?
Well, I think New Orleans will provide the experiential discoverer, someone who likes to get out and see so many things, a myriad of items to take in. And it's just not a 1 or 2 day stay. It is several days, because there's so many different adventures one can partake. We have great outdoors, great parks and the architecture and the walking tours. But then there's the food that is the fabric that weaves everything together. And then of course our music, which is comes in all sorts and shapes and sizes. In fact, Spotify, notice that there are 8 different subgenres of music that really emanate out of New Orleans, as opposed to just jazz or just gospel or just Zydeco. You've got a whole group of musical types. And so whatever you like, but the most important thing to remember is New Orleans is not the type of city that you want to go and sit by a pool and read a book. You want to get out into the city and become a local, as we say. Everyone becomes a local New Orleanian when they're in New Orleans, and they go down the streets we walk, and they eat the food we eat, and they listen to the music that we listen to. And the most important thing is more than 65% of the people that visit the city are repeat visitors, which says that people come back and they realize that they didn't have enough time to do everything they wanted to do, so they're going to come back and do more, or they want to keep doing what they're doing because they love being at the National World War II Museum, or they love eating at one of the 1,400 restaurants that we have in operation. And that's what our goal is now, to bring all this back and to ensure that our economy and the jobs can get stood up again, that these people can do the thing that they love to do, and that is to host people from around the world in New Orleans.
Yeah, well, I'll be booking a ticket as soon as I can. As soon as our borders open back up, I'll be heading over for a look. And no doubt, you've sold me on that summary.
Well,
there.
We look forward to having you come back on either doing a Pelicans game or a Saints game, and we can catch a couple of beers afterwards.
Oh, it sounds good to me, Mark. I'd love to thank you again for joining us on the Pelicans Scoop. It has been an absolute pleasure, and I really appreciate your time.
Thanks, Lyle. It's been a pleasure here too. Have a great day.
Yeah, you do. Thanks.
So thanks again to Mark Romig for joining us on the Pelican Scoop. Guys, that was a little while ago that we filmed that one, but it was an absolute pleasure to chat with him, and he's a huge advocate for New Orleans, as you could tell. And make sure you head over to neworleans.com to check out all of the stories that they have on there. It's an awesome website that I've got plenty of stories and research from, and definitely somewhere that you should check out. Guys, on that, another thing that you should check out is manscaped.com. They've teamed up with us at HoopBall and are providing 20% off if you use the code HoopBall20 at checkout. It'll also give you some free shipping, so make sure you go and give those guys a look, and make sure you go and have a look at their Lawnmower 3.0. That is an absolute beast. It's got a light, which is revolutionary for shavers, so make sure you go and have a look at that as well. Make sure you support New Orleans as well. You know, once all of this COVID is over and we're allowed to travel, make sure you head over there. It's a city that will definitely leave you wanting more. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. I know I'll be heading over there as soon as we can. But guys, I think that's time for today. Thanks again for joining us. As always, I'm Lyle Swithenbank, at Lyle Swithenbank on Twitter. At Hoopball Pels is the show on Twitter. Make sure you give us a like, a subscribe. As always, stay safe. We will see you next time. Bye for now.
This has been a HoopBall presentation.